Whether you're putting together a presentation, recording a video guide, or some gaming, screen recordings are handy ways to capture what is happening on your screen. If you're a Windows user, there's a few easy ways to record your screen. Firstly, let's take a look at Xbox Game Bar. This allows you to record an application window on your computer. Despite having the word Xbox in the name, you can use this to record most applications on a Windows computer, not just games. And Xbox Game Bar is included in Windows 10 and 11, so there's no need to install additional software. Xbox Game Bar can be found and opened from the Start menu or by pressing Windows key and G on your keyboard, and this will bring up the Game Bar overlay. If you've not used Game Bar before, there will likely be a default layout that pops up, however, our focus is on the Capture window. This can be opened by clicking the Capture button or by finding it in the Widgets menu. From the Capture window, you can do a few things, such as taking a screenshot, enabling your microphone, and most importantly, recording the application window you're currently using. Once you've decided if you want to keep your microphone muted or on, which can be handy for a voiceover, just click the Start Recording button to begin your recording. When you've finished recording, click the Stop button on the Capture pop-up, and your recording will be saved to the Captures folder in your User Videos folder. It's worth noting that the Game Bar cannot record the desktop or File Explorer and can only record the application you have active at the start of the recording. This is a downside of this method, but luckily there are some alternative solutions for recording your entire screen. You may think that PowerPoint is solely for creating slideshows and presentations, however, it features a fully fledged screen recorder that allows you to record a portion or your entire screen. I imagine this could be useful in the business setting where you may not be able to install additional software on your computer to record a screen, but have access to PowerPoint. To record your screen using PowerPoint, create a blank presentation and then select the Record tab on the ribbon bar. In the ribbon, there are a few different recording options, and you'll want to select the Screen Recording button. This will then hide PowerPoint and bring up an overlay where you can select your recording settings. Click Select Area and drag over the area of your screen that you want to record. And if you want to record your entire screen, simply drag from the top left to the bottom right of your screen. Once you've chosen which area of the screen you want to record, you'll see this area highlighted with a red dashed line. The two options left to choose are whether you want to record your microphone audio as well as your mouse pointer. And when you're ready to record, click record. A countdown will then appear on screen and your recording will begin. When you're done, press Windows key, Shift and Q to end the recording. And when the recording finishes, PowerPoint will pop back up into view and you can see the video on a slide. To export this from PowerPoint to a video file, all you need to do is right-click on the video and select Save Media As. Now, in comparison to Xbox Game Bar, being able to record the whole screen is a big bonus. However, you'll notice that the frame rate of the recording is a bit choppier and that system audio is not recorded. So let's move on to the final way of recording your computer screen. Now, before we jump into this, if you are finding this video useful, make sure to give it a like and subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos. OBS Studio is an incredibly powerful piece of software designed for streaming, recording, and vision mixing. However, it does also do a particularly decent job at screen recording and is what I use for making richer tech tutorials. OBS Studio can be downloaded for free from obsproject.com and is straightforward to install. When opening OBS for the first time, select Optimize for Recording, as this is what our primary focus is. You can then configure your video settings, which I will leave as default for the sake of this tutorial. As you'll notice, the preview is blank as your display has not been added as a source. So to add this, click the plus under Sources and select Display Capture. You'll see there's a variety of options if you're only looking to record an application or game. Click OK on the pop-up to add the new display capture and select the appropriate display from the display drop-down menu. And then click OK to finish off the process. If your display doesn't match the resolution of your OBS settings, such as a 4K display being captured on a 1080p OBS project, right-click on the Display Capture in Sources and select Transform Fit to Screen. OBS should have automatically detected your audio settings from Windows, so you should see the volume meters for desktop audio and your mic, indicating when sound is being emitted from your computer and when your microphone is picking up audio. By default, OBS will export videos as MKVs, though you can change this in the OBS output settings, amongst other options. You can also add multiple sources at one time on OBS, so you could also have a webcam feed on top of your desktop source if you wish to show your face alongside a screen capture. When you're all set up, all you need to do is click Start Recording, which can be found in the Control section on the bottom right, and your recording will start. When you're done, click Stop Recording. As you can tell, there is a bit more groundwork to do with OBS as far as the setup goes, but it can be quite powerful at getting the job done, as what I've shown for OBS only scratches the surface of what it can do. Those have been three different ways to record your screen on Windows. each with their own benefits and downsides, but each is handy and good to know in their own way. That's been it for this video. If you liked it, please consider subscribing. All the relevant links can be found in the description, as well as a written guide if you're wanting to start screen recording. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.